You've been waiting all day for this, and it's about time. Hi, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski here for EA Sports. And we are about set to drop the puck tonight. And there's the puck drop. Enough talk. It's time to find out what this is all about. Takes a shot. Scores! And look who it is! His first goal with his new EASHL team.
The excitement that he displays when that puck goes into the net, you know how much this means. You will never forget your first goal.
Guys, this is his first goal with this club here, and you know you never forget your first goal. I'm sure his teammates aren't going to forget it either.
Face off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Dumps it into the other end. Slides it over to Morris. Feeds the puck across to Brand. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Taken along the wall by Brand. Poked away by Golden. Oh, wow! That had some hot sauce on that collision.
Did it ever, James. I mean, you could see he was raring to get a hit in to try and change a little bit of the momentum, and the shoulder went into the player. That's a solid, clean hit.
Slides it over with pace to Drouin. Great pressure with the stick. And that's turned aside. Dumps it in. And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
You can feel the desperation ramp up as they're trying to get that equalizer. This penalty's really going to hurt them.
Here's a first look at the power play.
The power play guys are pumped here. They haven't had any chances tonight. Here's their first.
Puck picked up by Drouin. From the point, looks to make something happen. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Along the half wall with the puck. Here he is in front. Can't connect. Picked up along the board by Golden. And he comes up with the save. And they can't convert on the play.
Defensively, they're worn out. They can't get to the puck to clear the zone.
And they get that puck down the ice. Oh, that sounded like a car crash. Looks to set up at the point now. Answered the call on that play. Fabricius opts to hang on to it to get a whistle.
You start to wear down a little bit. You need your goalie to help you out.
AJ's ready to take the draw here on this power play. Long Island's got it in the offensive zone. Oh, what a stick save!
Sometimes you're in close, there's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all.
Here's a chance in front. Can't pull the trigger. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that? That goes off a twig. And just like that, from out of nowhere, comes up with the puck. The Mooseheads carry it along the wall. Into the corner, he takes the pass. Here's a pass down low. And they'll be forced to regroup as the puck escapes the offensive end. And now it's grabbed by Carpenter. And that pass goes awry. Sends it over to Brand. And he comes up with it. Taken by Golden. Oceanics on the attack. Long Island's got the puck along the boards. And that pass can't connect. A shot shuts him down. We'll get a face-off after the puck stays covered up. James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. Long Island's up 1-0. The Mooseheads win it in the defensive zone. Gets it over to Brand. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Referee Shilovec's hand is in the air. We've got a penalty coming up. Oceanics got the puck in the defensive end. Passes it over to AJ. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Well, the first job's going to be to kill this penalty off, James, but maybe they take a chance down a goal to see if they can get a shorty.
Long Island's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
Really doesn't matter if the power play scored before or not in this game, which it hasn't. You've got to focus in on the one that you've got right now. It's time to tee off on this one.
Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. Fires one. Oh, he stops it with the glove. Great reflexes there. Brand's gliding in for the faceoff as this penalty kill will continue. The Mooseheads take possession off the faceoff. Takes a hit on the play. And that goes off a player. Looking to clear the defensive zone. And they get it down.
Yeah, good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice.
Scores! Not the special teams unit we expected to deliver.
No, this is a real turning point in the game here as the shorthanded group capitalizes, gets on the board. Their bench explodes as the shorthanded goal ties the game. You just want to stay in touch with the game. You're down a goal, you're down a man. This is unexpected.
Special teams so important. Can they capitalize on this power play here with a faceoff? Moves it quickly over to Berube. Offside the call. We'll get a reset. Brand's ready for the draws. They will continue to try to kill off this penalty. Halifax wins the draw in the neutral zone. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. Takes it from the right side. There's the whistle. We got an offside. Here in the late goings of the period, you can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. France won the draw here in the open ice. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play.
Draw is up and ready to join the play.
Oceanics power play is over. What a disaster as they give up a shorthanded goal.
I certainly didn't like much about that power play. The shorthanded goal, of course, is the exclamation point.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. Long Island's got a hold of the puck off the draw. He clearly doesn't like that.
Carpenter scores! And he got right on his inside edges there to push right around the post. He beats the goalie there and he tucks it away. Oh, they got to tighten this up. This was a bad goal that they give up. Not so much the shot, but the defenseman's chasing the puck. He's behind the net. The wide open spot is in front of the net.
AJ's won it. Puck scooped up by Gates. Here's a shot. Just wide. From the top of the offensive zone here. Delayed penalty coming up here. Whistle stops the play.
Not a great time for that penalty to show up here. You only got a one-goal lead, and you better hope as you sit there your penalty killers do the job.
Halifax gets set to go to work on the power play for the first time tonight.
Great opportunity to get this game back to level. A power play trailing by one. This is a huge opportunity.
And that's blocked away. Trying to exit the defensive zone.
Tonight.
Things starting to get a little physical out there. Halifax has possession of the puck. And now it's over to Brad. And they turn it over in the neutral zone. Sends it over to Drouin. Takes the pass. Long Island's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. And that's broken up. Moves it to Drouin. Into the corner now. And that's knocked aside with the stick by Gates. Sends it deep inside the offensive zone. From in close. Oh, just gets a piece of it with the toe stop. And that'll put a bow on the first 20 minutes of action here tonight. We've got lots more still to come. Second period is just around the corner. teams had a chance to recharge. And the official set to drop the puck here on period number two. And now it's grabbed by Carpenter. Takes the feed. And offside, we'll get a reset here. We're still in the early stages of this period. Oceanics got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. Long Island's won the draw in the neutral zone. And no luck on that pass attempt. With authority. And that's broken up.
Sorry about your toes, James, that I just jumped on. That was a huge hit.
Picked up along the wall by Wheeler. Cross ice pass. And that's a great defensive heads up to force the turnover.
AJ's got the puck now. He had the go-ahead goal earlier.
Ref blows the whistle as the puck's covered up. Teams are ready for the draw. The linesman about to drop the puck. Long Island's won the faceoff. Golden's got it along the wing. Takes a shot. And the lane's clogged up blocking that. And now he moves it quickly to Wheeler. There's a hit on the play. Breakaway! Let's see what the officials are calling.
That's not great timing, James. I think you're trying to get back in the game. Now you've got to kill this penalty off, too.
Long Island's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
You can't doubt yourself on this power play. I mean, I know they gave up the shorthanded goal earlier, James, but you can't start questioning whether you can be an effective power play.
And they can't connect! Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. And a successful clearing attempt. Trying to engage a little physicality here. Halifax gains possession shorthanded. And they send it down the ice. Long Island's gained possession along the boards. Great chance in front. Turns it away.
They work that puck around for the 1T, and man, does he hammer it. But the goalie just beats him clean on that shot.
Puts it up front. Both sides back to even strength. A great effort by the penalty killers there.
Sometimes you go on the ice with the best of intentions. Scores! You get one, you get hungry for a second one. Even if you're not a goal scorer, you get that early. Now you want to hunt for a second goal.
Makes it a double on the play.
They tell you it doesn't have to hit the back of the net. It's just got to get over the goal line for it to count. That one does. The goalie had a big chunk of it. Just not enough.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Long Island's been the better team here over the last few minutes, increasing their lead to two. Good reach of the stick to knock the puck away. Sends it down low. Denies him! He got all of it! By Wheeler. Long Island's got control of it now from their own end. Here they are on the attack. Halifax has possession of it now. Puck hops out of the offensive zone. They'll be forced to do it over from center. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. AJ has won it off the faceoff. And that's intercepted, and they'll go on the attack. Poked away in the defensive end. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Circles back to center ice. Oceanics got it now. Turned aside with a glove.
Right from the most dangerous area on the ice. The goalie flashes the glove. That's an arrogant stop.
Past the midway mark in this period, Oceanics got a 3-1 lead. Let's it go! Off the mask of the goaltender, boy, right between the eyes.
Yeah, it did, James. You can hear that funny sound when the puck hit his mask. It doesn't sound like the post. It's not a stick. He shakes it off here, and the play will continue.
Halifax has it in their own end. Now a quick pass to Drouin. Oh, what a play!
I like it, James. He can't be held up once he gets rid of the puck. He gets it on the other side. can't get a hold of that pass. Through center along the wing. Off the left wing and into center. Oh, if there's going to be a regret in this one, that might be it.
Yeah, that play is right there to be had. They just miss the pass. The scoring chance goes away.
Locks them up on the draw as they take possession.
Oh, he laid a solid hit on him there. He was waiting for him and laid the shoulder right into him.
That might loosen a few of the choppers on that play. Oceanics got possession here on their own end. Halifax takes hold of the puck. Here's a short pass to Drouin. Poked away in the neutral zone. Here's a chance to his teammate. Here's a chance. Biggs brings the bell off the post.
Long Island's lead will stay the same. That's a really good chance that just by an inch or so hits the post and stays out.
Penalty coming up as the play's blown dead.
Ah, James, he wasn't quite sneaky enough with that. He wants to impede him, just not so much that he gets a penalty.
As they're about to drop the puck, the power play unit back out onto the ice for another opportunity.
Their power play hasn't been able to score yet. I think what's available, James, is the cross crease. The one-time play is there.
Slides the puck ahead to Berube. Great heads-up play to poke it away at the offensive end. Just slide! Chopping away at it. Trying to clear, and they do just that.
I thought they did a pretty good job there, James. That's a time you can get yourself running around in the zone. They didn't get there.
Halifax gains a hold of the puck against the boards, and they clear that puck. One last gas to make something happen on this power play.
Carpenter's up at the box.
Both sides are evened up now as the power play expires.
While the power play hasn't worked, they're going to have to look at all kinds of options here if they get another one. Maybe change the people that go out on the power play. Often wonder what the coach...
Scores! Oh, that was nice!
In stride, the snapper just beats the goaltender too quick and too accurate. He disguises the delivery point by keeping his feet moving right in stride, and the puck's past the goaltender before he can really set.
He used his make it snappy zone ability, guys, which is that quick release to send that puck right into the cage. And wow, he's just so dangerous when he fires in flight.
Thunderous hit! You can hear it all the way from up here!
Lots of times I miss playing, James. That's not one of them. I like I'm in a suit right now. That one hurt.
And there's the horn, two down, one more to go. Both teams will get a chance to catch their breath and get ready for a big third period next. The moment of truth has arrived for both these teams. Third period action set to go. Moment of truth for one team. Here we go. Third period is underway. Once again, I'll send it back down to my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, who is at ringside. Ray, we've got two periods played. How do you see this thing?
Halifax can't expect much more than what they've got. Low shots, a low goal total, and now you got to chase the game.
Puck is dropped, and we are back underway. With possession along the wall. From point blank, he scores! Deuces line!
makes your night. I'll tell you, it's great to score one. You get a second one. It's such a rush.
Thinking Hattie yet?
Oh, he should be. I mean, he's got two in the bag already. I'll tell you one guy that would be thinking Hattie, me. You want to use the player in front of the net as a screen if you can. This time, it's just about perfect. I don't think the goaltender ever picks it up.
Long Island's goal has now extended their lead to two here early in the third. You couldn't ask for a better start in the third here.
This is the way you draw it up. This is what you talk about between periods. Rarely does it come out, and your team is as effective as they were.
The Mooseheads will play it in their own end. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Errant pass, and they can't connect. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Puck grabbed by Carpenter. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Wheeler. Halifax looks to get things going now with the puck. Oceanic's got the puck. Quick pass to Golden. And now he angles it across to Marubi. And reads the play perfectly and picks off the pass. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Golden stick handling in his own zone. There's the whistle as the puck goes out of play. Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. Long Island's really controlled the pace of play these last few minutes, leading by two. Puck picked up by Gates. Long Island's playing it through the neutral zone. And here comes the pushback.
AJ's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
And they'll roll the power play unit right back out.
Way too many of 5-minute power plays just kind of fade into the ether. There's not enough urgency. They don't attack like they normally would on a 2-minute power play.
And the puck clears the zone. Long Island's got a hold of it against the wall. Quick feed to Gates. And that slides right out to center ice. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Scooped up along the wall by Gates. Long pass into the neutral zone. Can't connect! On their heels, trying to clear. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here.
Well, it's their job. Get it down the ice, get off the ice, get some new people out there.
Denies them on the play! Fabricius makes the save and hangs on for a stoppage of play. Hope everyone's enjoying the game here tonight. Another big face-off here on this power play. The Mooseheads win the draw. Here's the clearing attempt. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to AJ. Moved in front! Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Slides the puck down low. Glove save! How did he get a piece of that?
Everybody in the building knows they're trying to find him for the one-timer, and when it comes, can he...
Wow, completely ignored the whistle there.
Brand's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Look at this. He's calling him out here, Ray.
Yeah, he wants to go. He's not very happy. Well, the ref wasn't having any more of this. It just had enough, and both of them will head to the penalty box.
Another power play opportunity coming up here.
Just because the power play hasn't had a success run here, you can't focus in on that. You can't try to do too much. Move the puck the way that you practice. Get people to the front of the net. It's really a simple equation.
He's got a step. Oh, and that stays out with the toe save. Directs it on over to Marubi. Moves it to AJ. And there's the save. Puck moved back to center, forcing them to regroup. Long Island's got the puck. Moves it quickly over to Golden. Long Island's got the puck against the boards. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Slides it across. Long Island's coach can't be happy about that. A major penalty, and they come up with nothing on the power play.
Well, the power play went away pretty quickly there, didn't it? Nothing earned on a major penalty. That's a tough one to swallow.
Well past the midway mark of this period. It's a two-goal lead here tonight. 4-2 is where we're sitting. AJ's won the draw. Gets it front, and not much on that one.
Positioning's perfect. He gets into the butterfly and makes the save.
Halifax gains the zone. Easy peasy right there by Danny.
Danny's not really held up his end of the bargain tonight. Every shot is an adventure in there. He's lucky his team scored goals tonight.
Some last-second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. Taken by Gates. Oh, smart heads-up play to poke that one away. Nice feed from the left side up the middle. Oh, what a stop!
Fabricius has been working on controlling the puck after he stops it. Here he does a nice job.
Quick pass to Brand. The lane was plugged up and that shot's blocked. Quick pass to AJ. Couldn't complete the pass. Out front. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. Oceanics got control of it now here in the offensive end. Lays into the body on the play. And the puck departs the zone. Read perfectly with the stick at center by Wheeler. Feeds it down low. Here's a short pass to Drouin. Oceanics got the puck inside the defensive zone. Moves it around along the half wall. Inside of the final minute here in the third. Picked off. Hangs onto the puck. Oceanics trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. From one point man to another. He tries to tuck it in. Oceanics got a hold of the puck now. Look out, a two-on-one. He got rocked again.
He's got to get his head up here. They're going to be carting him off the ice.
That pass doesn't go. Wheeler's got it in the offensive zone. Textbook stop by Danny. Takes the feed from his own end. Makes his presence known on the ice. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Sends it over. Nice save. He scores!
Oh, hang on, James. Yeah, puck in the net. I don't know that this is going to count. Waved off.
Play set to resume, and you can see they're still frustrated by that non-goal call. Face-off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. It is all over. Challenge accepted, and they picked up the W as a result.
Yeah, they made the challenge. They looked around, and they wanted to play a competitive game. Looks like they made the right choice.
out here in the world of Chell, why not try playing some drop-in games to find new teammates? It's a great way to meet other competitors and a fun way to make new friends. Who knows? Maybe you'll find some squad mates you can invite to your own club.
The skates are sharpened, the sticks are taped, the ice is ready to go. James and Ray ready to bring it all. teams are lined up, and we are set to get things going. Puck is dropped. Let's do this hockey. Intercepted. Can't get it to go. Scores! And they get on the board quickly here in this one.
When we were talking to the coach this morning, he said on the road, his team has a tendency to slumber their way into games. Not today. Wow, did he hammer that. Too much power for the goalie to control it. It hits him and still goes in.
Nice job tying up his opponent. And a great save! Danny's opted to hang on to the puck for a faceoff. Lots of time left in this period. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. And a solid job tying up his opponent. Quick feed to Golden. And they won't connect on that one. And no luck on that pass attempt. Oh, and a smart heads-up play. Cape Breton's got the puck in their own end. There's the whistle icing the call. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Marshall's going to cover it up for a faceoff.
While his team's ahead, he wants to make sure the pace of the game stays at the level they like.
The Screaming Eagles get a hold of the puck in their own end. Takes it across the blue line. Quick feed down low. Oh, absolutely rocks them!
Yeah, they're going to try and set the tone of this game by using the body. There's a good, solid hit early in the game.
And that's off a stick. Can't connect on the pass. Turns it away on the slap shot. And that's knocked away. Gates takes the puck. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Sends the pass down low. And that's a smart heads-up play by Sass. And that pass can't connect. Puts it in deep. Grabbed along the boards by Kane. Passes right to the front. Flailing at it with his stick to try to get control. Golden's got the puck in his own zone. And they'll dump it in. Now he slides it up to Kane. Quick shot. And that takes guts to get in front of that one. Poked away at center by Sass. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. And a smart heads-up play to poke that away by Green. Errant pass, and they can't connect. From the point. Oh, what a stop! Sends it quickly to Kane. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Kidd's moving the puck through his own zone. Kane's going to play it against the half wall. And now it's over to Shaw. Big time stop there. Long Island's got it along the wall. And the puck skips out of the zone. They'll have to regroup. Long Island's looking to break out. Carries it across the line. Slides the puck down low. Centered out in front. Moves it to AJ. Gains the zone from the right. Sent into the opposite side. And they can't convert on the play. He was locked in there.
Shooters try to make it more difficult for the goalies by getting traffic in front of the net. He had to find it, and he did to make that save.
Oh, what a block. He'll get a pat on the back from the coach when he gets off, if he can get off. Moves it quickly over to Kidd. Receives the pass. Oh, absolutely hammers him. Sends the pass over. Takes the puck at the point. Taken along the wall by Golden. Long Island's gonna score.
Right back to the beginning of the night when the game was tied to start. Nobody has the upper hand anymore. Oh, everybody's staring behind the net at the puck carrier. Hey, guys, turn around. The guy that's going to shoot it is standing right in front of the net, and it's in the cage.
Golden's got it in the defensive end. And that plays offside. We got a faceoff coming up. Here in the late goings of the period, you can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Puck is dropped and play resumes. Nice pass. Slides the puck over to Shaw. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. From the left side, they enter the attacking zone. Back to the point it goes. Off a stick. Right to the middle. And that's off a stick. Scores!
The deadlock's broken. That's a big goal, and they put him into the lead. You've got to get rid of that puck in a hurry from that spot on the ice. You're in the high slot, you're open, but you know everybody's converging on you.
The Screaming Eagles have gotten themselves off to the start they wanted with an early lead.
Always better to play in front. You can dictate the matchups, you can dictate the pace of the game.
And with that, the first period comes to an end. Both teams will have a chance to get a breather, and they'll be back on the ice with period number two in not too long. And the opening face-off here in period number two is about set. The Screaming Eagles win it. Slides the puck across to Kane. Poked away by Kidd. Kane's taking it from his own end. Now over to Sass. That's blocked. Oceanic's got possession of the puck. Sends one over. And that one's broken up. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Feeds the puck to Kidd. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Long Island's looking to break out of their own end. And they'll keep on playing as icing is waved off. Picked up along the boards by Bolden. Doesn't go. Delayed penalty coming up here by the official. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
That penalty didn't go over very well right here beside me, James, on the bench. They know they're in tough now.
Long Island's got it, and they're on the attack. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
Not many times you get a clean look at the shot, so the goalies are always looking around this screen, trying to find it to make the save.
Here's a shot. Gobbles the puck up there with the chest. And we're going to get a stoppage here as the referee blows the play dead. Kane's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. Offensive zone faceoff and he wins the draw. Moves the puck down low. And it's turned aside by Marshall. Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. Trying to get out of the defensive end. And they get it down.
Yeah, good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice.
Shuts them down. Picked up along the wall by Golden. Right up front, and they can't connect.
Kidd's ready to join the play.
Long Island's power play has some chances, but they still are down a goal.
Well, there are times you look for your power play, at the very least, to gain a little momentum. They needed a goal. Now they still trail by one back to even strength.
Kane's got it against the boards. And he slides it quickly to Shaw. And that goes off a player in front. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. Cape Breton's got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. Great reach with the poke check. Long Island's got the puck along the wall. Unloads from the blue line. Stops him with a glove.
Good save. Positional save through trap.
Teams are ready to go, and we're about moments away from puck drop. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Quick pass to Kane. Couldn't complete the pass. Oceanics got control of it now from their own end. And a huge stop by the goaltender at point-blank range.
No room for the shooter. The goaltender snuffed it out.
Sent into the offensive zone. Takes control of the puck. Manages to hang on. And that pass goes off a stick. Cape Breton's in now. Long Island's grabbed a hold of the puck. Great forecheck by Kane. Tosses it to Sass. That pass doesn't go. Here's a short pass to Kidd. Excellent stick work on the play. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. And we'll get a breather here with offside the call. James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. The Screaming Eagles lead it 2-1 in what has been an entertaining game thus far. Moves the puck along the half wall. Into the corner. And they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. Looks for breakout options behind his own cage. Quick feed to Kane. Long Island's got it in the offensive zone. Trying to get it out of their own end. And there we go. Icing is the call. Late goings of this period. Cape Breton's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. And that's picked off in the defensive end.
Cape Breton's worked hard to be in the right position tonight. They've had their skating legs, and they're stealing pucks all over the place.
And makes the routine save.
Marshall's been a leader tonight. You don't need a speech, you need to play well. He's done that tonight, and he's kept his team right in it.
Both centers ready to take the draw here coming up. Long Island's won the draw, and they'll go to work. Tries to get the puck to Golden. Can't complete the pass as it goes off a stick. Moves it to Golden. And that one's broken up. Gets the puck over to Green. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Sass. Oh, what a little stick lift on the play. It comes up with the puck. Stopped by the goaltender. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Handles the puck. Dumps it into the O-zone. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. He scores!
Well, what a great way to go into the end of a period. You score, you put a mark up on the board, and you know that you've really put a dent in the other team's confidence.
With just seconds to spare.
When the puck came to him, he had to settle it down first in order to get control and maintain possession, guys. His magnetic superstar ability was that first touch to corral it in, and that's how he was able to go on and score there.
Can't get it to go. Well, two periods down and one more still to come. Third period action right after we get a clean sheet of ice. Been a great night for hockey so far. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's drop the puck on this third period. Third period is now underway in this very tightly contested affair so far. Cape Breton's got the puck along the wall. And a bad pass, and they'll be forced to start all over again outside the offensive end. Quick feed down low. Great heads-up play with the stick by Sass. What a steal in his own end. And they keep the pressure on. And that banks off a stick. Great reflex on display tonight on his part. Long Island's got the puck along the boards.
What a great example of unending pressure.
Moves it quickly over to Green. The Screaming Eagles played along the boards. And they won't connect on that one. The Screaming Eagles played along the boards. Oh, what a hit, Ray. You can hear that from here. How about you?
Yeah, oh yeah, that'll give you a headache. That was a solid hit.
And that's poked away by Kidd. Oh, and it's another save on the play. And the puck clears the zone. Cape Breton's got a hold of it against the wall. Couldn't complete the play. Scooped up along the wall by Kane. A blast! And he stands tall in goal. Puck is cleared out of the defensive zone. Cape Breton's working the transition through the middle of the ice. Long Island's got control of the puck. An easy save by Danny. And as he opts to freeze the puck, we get a whistle.
Starting to look like a little bit of a fire drill in the zone, so this is a good play.
Gates helps his team out by defending one-on-one situations, guys. His shutdown zone ability means he can be a difference maker for his team's overall defense.
Puck scooped up by Golden. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Tried to pick a spot, but that goes off the side of the net. And that one's blocked! Trying to get back on the attack now. Along the wing, up the neutral zone. Long Island's got it from behind the net. Slides it on over to Berube. Textbook poke check by Kane. Handles the puck at the point. Pokes it away in his own end. Cape Breton's got it in their own zone. Return pass.
Some guys shy away at this time. Others, James, they lock right in. That's when the game is most tight. When it's right on the line and everything that you do is under the microscope.
Cape Breton's got the puck against the half wall. Denies him on the play. I think it's a chance for a breather here as he hangs on and covers the puck up.
Who, for the players or for you?
Well, you know, I won't complain.
Sass makes great passes to help his team keep the play moving, guys. His tape-to-tape zone ability means he can put the puck right on his teammate's stick without it bobbling away. And that's how he loves to contribute to the play.
Cape Breton's got him along the wall. Can't connect! Here's a pass down low. Sends it down low. The Screaming Eagles looking against the half wall. Oh, they telegraph the pass and he picks it off. Great defensive effort with the stick. Quick pass to Kidd. Strong feed from along the boards. And they can't convert on the play. Gains the zone from the right side. Puck dumped in. Long Island's got it behind the net. Here they come. Cape Breton's got the puck. And now he tries to get it across to Green. Long Island's got the puck. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Oh, what a stop!
Oh, that's a hard save there. He's battling for position, battling for a sight line. He can't really see much through that screen, but he still makes the save.
Here's a short pass to Kane. From the boards, he takes that pass. Scores on the redirect, the old hippity-tippity.
Gets himself into position, James. I don't know if that's what they call it or if it's just you that calls it that.
It's me.
Okay, good. It's still a heck of a play because you get yourself in there, you've got your stick on the puck, and the goalie just can't catch. direction.
Did you like it, by the way?
No.
The Screaming Eagles have jumped out to a one-goal lead here in this third.
Well, pretty clear this game's not going to spread out at all. Two very equal teams battling it out.
And that's a great heads-up play in the offensive zone. And no luck on that pass attempt. The Screaming Eagles are in transition. Hard hit on the play.
Wow, did he ever finish him hard. And when he dropped, he also dropped his stick. Now he's got to collect himself. Looks like a yard sale out there.
Sends it out right in front. And they can't connect. And we got a delayed penalty coming up here. And let's see what the... Definitive call is on the ice.
I wonder if they get a minute or so into this penalty kill. If they get the goalie out, they need the tying goal.
Shaw's got a chance to use his zone ability to help the power play put one up on the board here, guys. Let's see how they do.
Cape Breton's won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. And that's broken up in the defensive zone by Shaw. Grabs the puck here in their own end. And that's all she wrote from this one here tonight. Well, they felt like they were ready for prime time, and I guess they were proven wrong.
Yeah, time to go back to the drawing board. Challenge somebody else next time.
Maybe turn that controller upside down, right?
You lift me up, you bring me down, you make our whole world go around. We put our time and faith in you. We may waver, but you never do. You're good as gold, you're right as rain. You take no credit and you take no blame. So lift me up and bring me down. Drop the needle, spin the record. Meet up with the boys in the morning. street. You kick the roses with your feet. You each other in the teeth.
Welcome back to the world of Chell. It's Carlin Bathe right here with you. I just wanted to give a tip to all of you looking to surprise your opponent with a big hit. Just make sure you connect and don't put yourself out of position and unable to defend. Clean hits truly are an art form, and a lot of it comes down to timing. Good luck with those defensive assignments.
Standoff, call me a rock.
Welcome back, everyone. You know, for all you ODR fans, we have a bunch of outdoor rinks here for you to play on within the World of Chell. Take to the ice in ones or pro-am and experience world-class outdoor environments against some great competition.
Welcome, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski to this EA Sports Showdown, and we are fired up. Let's drop the puck already. Face-off just moments away. The victorious start with possession as we are now underway. Pass to Kong. Here's the pass. And oh, so close on that play. And that's snapped away in the defensive end by Golden.
Oh, that was stinky.
Turns him away.
Oh, he looks like he's banged up there. He's going to try and finish the shift, but he's pretty clearly not at 100%.
Nowhere for that shot to go through. Moves the puck. Long Island's looking to break out of their own end. Berube's got the puck. Maintains possession. Here he is on the backhand. Makes it look easy with the stop.
Once he drops into that butterfly, he's pretty confident he's got most of the net covered. He slides across to make the save.
Slides it diagonally to Berube. Oh, a violent collision in the open ice. Feeds it over to Gooby. Takes the feed. Long Island's got the puck in their own end. And that's picked off. Toronto's got a hold of the puck. Sends a pass over. Takes the pass. And that's knocked away by Golden. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Can't connect on the pass.
That's close, James. The goaltender ends up beating the shooter to the post. As that looks like it's a goal, but it's shut down.
Quick feed to Gooby. Stopped by the goaltender. Oceanics in transition. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Toronto's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Long Island's got a hold of it along the wall. Grabs the puck in the corner. The Victorious have it from their own end. And that pass can't connect. Way too much congestion blocks that. Moves it to Gooby. Long Island's going to play the puck from behind the cage. Stays with it. Gets a hold of the puck here at his own end. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Scores! That is a clinical finish.
And what a great shot. I mean, he gets in the offensive zone. He's looking shot all the time. He's also loving the one-timer, and he does not miss.
Guys, his 1T zone ability is absolutely lethal. Defenders don't want to get in the way of it. Goalies can't catch up to it, and that right there is why it went in the back of the net.
Toronto's ready to go on the attack. Dumped into the opposite corner. Passed up ahead. Here's a chance on the doorstep, and he makes the save. The Victorious take possession in the defensive end. Streaking into the attacking zone for the right. Sends it across. Can't connect. Scores, and we are tied.
They've been scratching around the edges of this game, and now they get it back to level. This is a terrific shot. He beats the goaltender, but the goalie gets a chunk of it. Not enough. He can't slow it up.
Here in the back half of this period, the next goal could be a big one as we are tied. And sends it just out of reach. And he slides it quickly to Kong. Slides the puck over. Toronto's going to play it from the corner. Makes a save. Cool and calm under pressure. Danny's. Oh, he ripped that right after the whistle.
What's he thinking? Kong's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Here in the later stages of this period, it's all tied up. AJ's won the faceoff. The Victorious get a hold of the puck along the boards. Long Island's got control of it now from their own end. The Victorious have it in the offensive end. Handles it along the blue line. Grabbed along the board by Gooby. Moves it quickly over to Kong. Broken up by Gates. Nearing the point. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame.
Oh, I love it.
Scores! There's his first in the new colors.
Always good to get on the board to show that you're able to help your new team. You want to show them that you're ready to play. He's on the board. He'll feel better now.
Guys, he's got a nose for the net, and that right there was his 200th career goal in the EASHL clubs. You know he's stoked, and so are his teammates.
Sends it in deep. Icing is the call. We'll get a reset. Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Toronto's won the draw.
It's almost like he dug in a little deeper there after the icing to win that draw.
There's the whistle. Let's see what the referee saw.
As soon as that penalty's called, everybody's looking at the clock to see how much time's left. This is an important penalty kill.
Toronto sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight. Oceanic's got a hold of the puck. He scores!
A finish late in the period seems to carry over into the next period more often than not. What a great time to score. He's in the bumper position in the middle of the slot. They move the puck around and find him in the middle, and he makes no mistake.
And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. There's the buzzer. 20 minutes in the books. Second period just around the corner. Period number two seems ready to go. The teams are set. My broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, is also set. Let's do this. Here we go. Middle frame now underway as the puck drops. Poked away at center ice. Takes a nice feed up through the middle now. Play blown dead. Let's get the call. The Victorious are going to serve two for tripping here. And the power play unit takes to the ice their first chance to try to make something happen in this game. Puck cleared from the defensive end.
Just because the power play hasn't had a success run here, you can't focus in on that. You can't try to do too much. Move the puck the way that you practice. Get people to the front of the net. It's really a simple equation.
They'll get set to drop the puck as this power play continues. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. From the blue line, they take control of it. And he's taken down, the official's arm signaling for a penalty. And the play is whistled dead. Here's the call.
As he's trying to defend, he just wants his stick on the puck, but he gets it into the other guy's feet, and the tripping penalty is called.
He grabs the puck here at the point. To the front! And the traffic neutralizes that threat. And the puck is cleared to a safer spot. And that's somehow stayed out of the net. Here's a chance right out in front. Great reach with the poke check by Gooby. Nice job to escape the zone. Long Island's got a hold of it against the wall. Puts it to the front of the net. And that one's broken up. Great block there. Denied by the goaltender. And there's the whistle as he elects to slow things down a little.
A pretty good decision here with the play starting to break down in front of him.
AJ's at the faceoff dot, ready to win this, draw on the man advantage. Off the draw, and he ties up his opponent. And a stiff break set up. Puck moved over to Golden. Oh, a whole lot of truculence with that.
That hit was delivered with intent. That's not to rub somebody out of the play. That's to send a message.
From the right side, they gain the zone. Oh, look out.
AJ's not interested in dropping the mitts and going at it.
Puck exits the zone. Taken along the wall by Golden. And that's poked away. Keeps hold of the puck. Right in front of the net. And that's blocked. Takes the feed. Moves it on over to Palm. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. It's a two-goal lead we're looking at with the score 3-1. The victorious win the draw here in the neutral zone. And that's deflected. And now it's grabbed by Mittelstadt. Toronto's across the blue line. Couldn't find the intended target.
Palm's able to take that quick pass. He's already got a couple of goals. He's looking for a third.
The victorious take it from the side. Here he is, tries to tuck it in. And he makes the save on that play. Gains the zone through center. A chance in front. Oh, how did that stay out? What a toe stop on the play. Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. The victorious win the draw. Receives the pass. Carries it in. Right in the slot. And they can't finish that one.
Oh, he's going to be kicking himself for that. The play was there. He just doesn't execute that last pass for the scoring opportunity.
Turn that one aside.
Into the butterfly, slides across to make the save.
Right up the gut. Here they go. Slides the puck down low. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Toronto's got possession here in the offensive zone. Sends it in on the attack. Quick pass to AJ. Errant pass and they can't connect. Here he is on the wraparound. Danny's going to give everyone a chance to breathe and hang on to the puck. More than half the period has expired. The victorious are up 3-1. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Into the attacking area from the left side. On the heels of their blades, trying to get it out. Puck grabbed by Gates. Dishes it to Berube. Here's a short pass to Gooby. There's the whistle. Let's get the call from the officials. Golden's called for tripping. He's off to the box. And the man advantage unit goes right back to work.
Well, they've earned another power play, James. Of course, that starts with an offensive zone faceoff. They've had success earlier in the game. They'll want to double up on that now if they can.
Danny's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Can they capitalize on this power play? Here comes the faceoff. Nice job tying up his opponent. Toronto's got possession of the puck. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Toronto's on the attack. Tees it up. He scores! Putting the special in special teams tonight.
The extra work they've done, the way that they move some people around, has helped them cash in more than once on the power play. There's not much of a line here between him stopping this and what happened. The puck hit him and went into the net. I thought he had it.
The victorious win the faceoff. Toronto's got the puck in the defensive end. And here's the pass to Kong. Sends the pass over.
some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. Makes a
big save.
Stopped with ease.
Boyce is bathing in a big lead here. Doesn't have to do much in his end either. Not many shots.
Nice pass. And they're in the final minute of the second. And that pass is redirected. Oceanics moving it into the offensive end. Here's a chance. Gives them nothing in front.
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good save in close.
And there's the buzzer bringing the second period to an end. You don't want to go home yet, do you? Third period action still to come. Both teams seem fresh after that second intermission. We're ready to drop the puck on period number three. Well, this has been an absolute blowout through the first two periods as we get underway here in the third. Ray Ferraro is between the benches at ice level. Ray, we've got 40 minutes played so far. How have you viewed things?
Long Island's players have been a turnover machine tonight. Every time they have it, it seems like they force it into an area where they lose it. They lose the puck, they're losing the game.
Lots of time left in this period. Toronto's got a little more jump in their step tonight. They lead it 4-1. The Victorious take it across the line. Moves right to the middle, and he can't find his man. Moves it over one-on-one with the goaltender. And it falls apart.
Yeah, I'm not sure that breakaway was the way he planned it. I mean, you get into the clear and you're excited. You got an idea of what to do, but that wasn't it.
Handles the puck from the neutral zone now. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Picked up along the boards by Mittelstadt. The Victorious will play it from the defensive zone. Oh, look at this chance. Takes that one right in the logo. Denies him again.
Right spot, makes the double save. Positioning does it all.
And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. To his teammate. Oh, Sabin Dawson scores. Right on the doorstep. He pounces off a rebound and puts it home.
Guys, this is his first goal with this club here. And you know, you never forget your first goal. I'm sure his teammates aren't going to forget it either.
Puck is dropped and play resumes. Directed over to Gooby. Fails to find the open man. Picks off the pass.
The Victorious are still in a tight game here. One of the reasons they're in it is their positional play has been outstanding.
Toronto's looking to break out of their own end. They've got numbers. It's a 2-on-1. And they can't convert on the play. Into the corner of the attacking area. Quick feed to Kong. And that's the hat trick. Listen to this place.
And here come the Hats. This tradition, although I will tell you, they collect the hats up. They used to give them to us, and you're like, what am I gonna do? I'm not wearing somebody else's hat.
Toronto's all smiles on the bench next to you, aren't they?
Yeah, they're having lots of fun. Not so much on the other side, where this night has been a nightmare.
AJ's one possession, and they'll go the other way with it. The Victorious carried along the wall. Long Island's got the puck along the boards. Couldn't catch up to that pass. Across the line from center. The Victorious grab possession to the puck. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone.
Wow.
Scores! Now it's a two-goal game.
A
Well, now they've got something to build on here. They feel now, I'm sure, like they're in the game, because when you're down three, it seems forever away.
Past the midway mark in this period, Long Island's got to find a way to get a few more goals here as they still trail by a pair. And it's poked away in the neutral zone. Nice heads-up play there. Right on the doorstep! And a nice takeaway in the defensive end by Mittelstadt. Quick cross-ice pass to Kong. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. And that's broken up. Whacks it into the offensive zone. Turn that chance aside. As he slides it, puts it into the back of the net!
It seems believable that you can tie this up. You've still got some time.
Long Island's got one back here, yes. Ray. How big is that?
Well, it does a lot, James. It changes your mindset. It changes the way you approach this. And you don't have to be reckless trying to get just one goal.
The Victorious get a hold of it. Throws it in. Feeds it down low. Toronto's gained possession along the boards. Oh, and it stays out with the toe save.
Smothered that in close chance.
And he's able to handle that one. Puck is frozen, and we'll get a face-off. This is a face-off. They'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. AJ's won the draw. Gets down low and blocks the shot. And a great save! Quick feed down low. Here's a chance to set up now. Stopped by the goaltender. Big time shot block there. Scores!
Really good effort here to continue to push along, try and find a way to crack the defense. They've done it, and this game is tied.
Absolutely clutch! Long Island's late third period goal certainly opens up a lot of decision making for the coaches, doesn't it?
It does, but they must feel pretty good about their position because they just scored. I suspect they've got a little bit of a leg up even though the game is tied.
Takes the feed behind his own net. And he moves it up to Gooby. Toronto's on the attack. Along the half wall with the puck. Long Island's got the puck. Moves it to AJ. Sends the pass down low. That's some smart heads-up defensive play by Mittelstadt. Long Island's got a hold of the puck now. Fires it into the offensive zone. Less than 60 seconds left here in the final frame. Gets the puck in deep. Here's an offensive chance. Long Island's got the puck along the wall. Fires it into the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to AJ. Oh, no luck as it goes off the outside of the post.
So close to this game being untied, but a really good chance hits the pipe and stays out.
From his own end, he moves it up ahead. Big time stop there. Long Island's got a hold of it along the wall. Toronto's got it across the line. There's the whistle. We've got an offside. Both centers ready to take the draw here coming up. Toronto's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Mittelstadt. And with that, we are heading to overtime. Get those OT picks in on social media, and we will see if we can find a winner next. The moment of truth has arrived. Overtime is set to go. All right, listen to this place. The electricity so thick you could cut it with a knife. Sudden death, overtime. The puck is dropped. Let's go. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. Right up front. Under siege, trying to get it out of their zone. And mission accomplished, Ray.
Yeah, late in the game, it's defensive blue line puck out, offensive blue line puck in. Nothing turned over at those two spots.
Grabs it in his own end. Toronto's moving it up the ice. And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Berube's picking up steam. He says, let's get physical on that play. Long Island's got a hold of it against the wall. Quick pass to Kong. Slides the puck down low. Strong defensive effort. Danny's going to hang on for a whistle. A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. The victorious win it. Tees it up from the point. Moves the puck down low. And that's some great pressure in the offensive end by Gloomy. On the doorstep. And he makes the easy save.
Great read by the goalie going side to side to take that one away.
That opportunity's rejected. Danny's going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around as the shift gets long. This helps.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. AJ's won the draw deep in the defensive zone. Up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it. Answered the call there.
Sharp reaction save.
Shuts him down.
Oh, well done by the goaltender here, James. He makes the save, but he deflects it away at the same time.
Dumps it in. The victorious get a hold of the puck along the boards. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. Picked up along the wall by Gates. Moves the puck. Strong defensive effort. The victorious scoop it up along the boards. Couldn't connect on that pass. Scoops up the puck here. Slides it across to Kong. Knocked away by Gates. Long Island's got possession of the puck. And he coughs it up with the pass. Oceanic's got it into the offensive zone. And he easily stops that one. A critical draw here. Toronto's got it in the defensive zone. Scooped up along the wall by Gooby. Nice dish from the left wing.
Cobb's already got three, James. When it's going good, you look for more.
And pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end. Quick feed down low. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Long Island's got the puck along the boards. Gates plays it now. Kong's got it along the wing. Here's a short pass to... He scores! There it is! OT winner! Toronto's playmakers the difference here as they come away with the overtime victory.
Even see their coaches fist pump behind the bench. The overtime win